that right there is why I need a smaller roller. I could just load a couple tools up in there, move around the shop rather than lug this big thing around. This is part of my rhythm. Let's see how fast we can do this without sacrificing a plant. This is a newer model, so they changed up some stuff, so it's a bit more difficult, so y'all didn't know I had one of those, right? Y'all see that? Give me some trouble with Teflon nut. They're not fun. So, but I'm done with this. I can put this back for now. I'm past that point already. So far. I just can't fucking.
Remember, you didn't roll the window, right?
No.
Okay, but don't.
Shh. What you doing?
Can't get this part past.
So you know what Mel does?
What?
He puts all this in first?
I know.
And he swings this out.
I don't know how the fuck he does it.
Just this. That gives you enough room.
This loosens up the top, I know that.
And then the top, and then you have enough room just to slide this in. It's real easy.
He has to squish that spring down.
But you have a real spoon.
That should be more than that.
Everybody left me by myself, but thankfully that kiwi strawberry. Again, if y'all missed it in the beginning, I do have a link for this tool. It's not only this size of plates, it has one other size, two plates, and of course the collapsing rod. This doesn't only work for Nissan, this is actually a Mercedes tool. So if you want, pick yourself up one. You never know when you're gonna need it. And it's fairly inexpensive, $74 to $80 online. Like I said, link in the description down below.
Bought your own tool for that?
Fuck yeah!
Oh yeah, 100 times.
Did you buy it online or did you buy it from one of the dealers?
Nah, I'm not. That side. This is that one. This is the one that I have issues with. I think they changed up in 16. This is a 17. Or maybe they changed up in 17. Ah. It's not even on there right.
Thank you.
all that work. I don't know what they did different about this year model. I really don't know. But it's definitely a piece of work on the driver's side. almost done, right? Check it out. Again with the, I don't know, I don't why I don't have more of these. Because when I was using this, when I was using this air ratchet a lot, this little swivel came in so nice. And even though I got the stubby, I don't know why I don't have the swivel on it, but let's finish up. Fluff, why'd you stop using it and why are you using it now? Well, there's lock nuts on there. So it's my electric ratchet. I told y'all the electric ratchet is not that strong. That's why I put in spark plugs and stuff with it and 10s and 12s. This one, when it catches, it'll. Right? Sometimes your hand gets stuck. It's doing that and it gets stuck and then you gotta figure out some way to disconnect the air hose to release the tension. It sucks. I don't even know why I plugged it back in. Alright guys, so one last look at this tool. As you can see, these are the plates that I use for the Nissan. Got smaller plates and then the telescoping compressor. So yes guys, this does work for multiple vehicles. You just got to know which one to use on your vehicle. And as I said before, I do have a link down in the description below. It helps me, Amazon affiliate link. So that's about it for today. I'm gonna slap the tires on tomorrow. I'm gonna line the vehicle and then I'm gonna adjust that radar assembly that y'all saw me throw on. So please check out the merch store, please. Okay, got these videos right here. Subscribe right there if you haven't already. Merch, deuce. Oxidation on the drop bell. I'll do a video on this. All right, so this seal, they did not approve these. Is there sufficient pressure for them? Well, I got a whole bunch of parts right there. And then I bought this one because it was a special edition one time.